Christ tells us that we must love one another. He makes no distinction. What does he mean by this? I think he wants to say that we shoot every person, every counter and cross, familiar and unfamiliar, stranger, attractive or not, right. This is a person with eternal destiny. This is the man that God from oblivion called to life so that he makes his unique contribution into the life of mankind. Humanly, we may not like that person. He may be alien to us. He may be incomprehensible to us. But he was called by God and put into the world to bring something into this world that we are unable to contribute. And more than that, it's placed in my life path in order to something was revealed to me, to open up to me firstly my inability to accept every person with love in my heart, to see every person like a living icon of Christ. Maybe not Christ in glory, but Christ crucified, Christ disfigured by beating, but Christ an icon. Do we know how to look at each other? I'm afraid that we don't know how, that there are people who are close to us, dear, others at best are simply alien. And we need to pay special attention to these strangers. After all, they put the question before us, are you with Christ or without him? Because this man whom Christ loved until the death of the cross, you don't want to know. He is alien to you. He is incomprehensible to you. You don't care about him. If this person wasn't in the world, you would be just as easy and good. Is this Christian love? We must learn for every person we meet, look and say, this is the icon of Christ, this is the image of God, this man is a messenger of God. He is sent in order to teach me something, to bring me something, to put a question before me, a requirement of God. Sometimes we know how to do this after a while, and sometimes we don't know how to do it until the moment when it seems to be too late. I recall a conversation with a Russian priest, early migration, who was a soldier in the White Army, who all the years of his emigrant life dedicated to the fight against Bolshevism, who rejected Stalin with all his heart. At some point, he learned that Stalin had died, and at that moment something happened to him that he didn't expect. He thought, what if God judge Stalin like this, how I tried him and still can't stop judging. I hated him. It's really God when he stands before him, he will be greeted with hatred, rejection, and this is not for a while, but for eternity. And I remember how he told me that he was so terrified of himself that he threw himself into the altar, threw himself on his knees and said, Lord, sorry for the hate I had for this man. He is now before the last judgment. God, don't accept my condemnation against him.